Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla, claims that a new manganese battery could be crucial to increasing EV production. Elon Musk confirmed that manganese is being investigated as a cathode material in a speech to Tesla Gigafactory Berlin employees during the factory's opening ceremony. Alternatives to affordable LFP battery materials will be required to scale EV batteries to the 300 terawatt-hours of annual production needed to achieve sustainable transportation, he said. If you haven't already, please subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications on new videos. Elon Musk has long advocated for the use of manganese as a cathode material in electric vehicle batteries, and he recently reaffirmed his position during the Tesla Gigafactory Berlin opening ceremony. When asked about graphene's potential as a battery-making material at an address to German Gigafactory employees, Elon Musk responded, "I think there's an interesting possibility for manganese." Tesla's CEO has previously stated that the business is looking into manganese as an alternative to the iron or phosphorus it currently employs in its LFP batteries for its standard range vehicles. According to Musk, the world will require at least 300 terawatt-hours, TWh, of battery cell manufacture at some point in the future in order to fully transition away from fossil fuels. Only materials as inexpensive and numerous as those found in LFP battery packs, as well as manganese, can achieve such scale. The recent meteoric jump in nickel prices triggered by Russia's invasion of Ukraine only confirmed Tesla's CEO's point, as the typical nickel-cobalt-aluminum battery components used in long-range electric vehicles are far from cheap and plentiful. This is why Elon Musk wants to add manganese to the iron and phosphorus used in the manufacture of more affordable EV batteries, in order to eventually achieve the hundreds of TWh a year production required for sustainable transportation. Tesla has already used manganese in some of its Powerwall battery cells, but Elon Musk said at yesterday's Giga Berlin opening ceremony that it can and should become a viable alternative to the common battery materials used now. We'll need tens, if not hundreds of millions, of tons on a large scale. So, in order to scale, the materials utilized to manufacture these batteries on a big scale must be common materials. Elon Musk stated that Tesla sees possibilities in manganese-based cathode battery chemistry. The industry, according to the CEO, has to focus more on the battery supply chain, all the way down to the minerals. Musk was asked about graphene-based batteries during a speech to Tesla Gigafactory Berlin employees celebrating the delivery of the factory's first Model Y. Musk expressed his skepticism, as did many others in the business, due to the difficulty of producing graphene, but he did indicate that Tesla was working on developing batteries out of more materials. Tesla, like the rest of the industry, will focus on nickel-based chemistries for longer-range vehicles and iron phosphate for shorter-range vehicles for the foreseeable future, according to the CEO. However, Musk made a quick but intriguing remark about a manganese-based battery, saying, "I think manganese has an interesting potential." For a long time, Tesla has been looking into adding additional manganese in its battery cells. It is pretty straightforward to produce a cathode that is two-thirds nickel and one-third manganese, which will allow us to make 50% greater cell volume with the same quantity of nickel, Musk said during Tesla Battery Day in 2020. The CEO didn't go into detail today, other than to state that Tesla was working on it, but it sounded like it could be a viable option alongside nickel and iron-based chemistries. On a very vast scale, we'll need tens, if not hundreds of millions of tons. So the materials required to mass-produce these batteries must be common materials, or you won't be able to scale. Several research groups have published articles on promising manganese-rich cathode batteries, which could provide attractive possibilities, with a greater energy density than iron phosphate batteries and a lower price than nickel-rich batteries. Tesla already uses manganese in several of their battery chemistries, but it isn't a major component in any of them. NMC chemistry, for example, contains a lot of manganese, and Tesla has already employed the chemistry in its Powerwall. Nissan also employed a manganese-rich cathode in the Leaf's first battery. The CEO emphasized the importance of concentrating on battery mineral supply in order to hasten the transition to electric vehicles and renewable energy. Tesla predicts that the world will require 300 terawatt-hours of battery cell manufacture to fully transition to a sustainable planet, according to Musk. You're watching Tech Sector, experts who break news about Tesla, electric vehicles, and anything tech, day after day. Be sure to check out our other videos for all the latest news, and make sure to subscribe to stay in the loop, and as always, have a great day.